for me, Brian Wilson at his best is, you know, it is for the post-rock and roll generation, for anyone who came of age after the Beatles, he is our classical music.
It was rock and roll, but then all of a sudden it was pretty rock and roll.
It seemed like, with his music, there are no real rules. You're like stepping into his world.
And there's no one else that even comes close to essentially, you know, creating a genre. Part of the blessing and the curse of being, you know, truly creative kind of genius person is that you can't hang it up. You don't really have a choice. You have to do this.
I'm going home.
You know, he's been blessed with the fact that he has done something he loves his entire life. But do you think at 65 or 66 years old, he has to be out there flying on jets over to the UK or flying around the United States or driving in a bus? I mean, it's his lifeblood, in my opinion.
One, two, three, go.
After we did Smile, it seemed like there was, I don't know, in a weird way, it was like reaching an artistic pinnacle. In many ways, more than just artistic, even for Brian.
Yeah, it was personal.
He got more confident, I think. I think he did open up a little bit more and felt like, maybe I can do this again.
Well, it inspired me to want to go one step further and get Lucky Old Sun.
Work so hard for my pay.
I'm inspired because I like spiritual music. You know, I like the spiritual concept. That Lucky Old Sun is a spiritual record. It's about going to a new place. It's about staying where you are and trying to make the best of your life.
Oxygen, oxygen, right to the brain.
And it was just one of these things where you were skeptical, like, are we gonna be able to pull this off? And is this, you know? And it just kind of kept surprising us, you know? And then we were like, we all agreed, okay, it's a bit too poppy and happy. We need a heavier couple of songs. And that's when Midnight's Another Day came about. Mostly my collaboration was just to try to tweak the lyrics to tell a story. There's sort of a semi-autobiographical thread running through them about Brian's life and his life in Los Angeles.
It's just about capturing the mood of Southern California and the mood of LA in the 50s and the 60s.
If the Wilsons hadn't been in California and in LA, there would be no strong California identity.
Surfing, cars, you know. I get around from town to town. Gotta find a new place where the kids are hip, you know.
He made the experience accessible in something that kids all over the country and the world could relate to, even if they'd never been there, would never surf in their entire lives.
So sweet. Surfer silhouettes, the sun went into the sea.
He was someone who understood the dream, he needed the dream, and then he became this source of the dream and the way it was. The myth was spread, and in Lucky Old Son, he's not perpetuating a dream. He's really kind of reflecting a life and a world he sees. It's sort of the grace of perspective.
Southern California dreams wake.